Right, let's do a Capm calculation with the HP10bII Plus financial calculator. To start, we're going to identify the three variables that we need to perform this calculation: the risk-free rate, the market rate of return, and the share beta. For the risk-free rate, we'll be using a value of 3.48% or 0.0348. For the market return, we're using 9.3% or 0.093. And for beta, we're going to use a value of 0.82. So where do these values come from? A 10-year government bond yields are considered investments that are risk-free, so we use that for the risk-free rate. The market average rate of return, I've used the 10-year average return of the ASX 200. And for a share beta, just Google it. I've used BHP's beta as an example here. So let's plug these values into the formula. First, we have the risk-free rate added to the beta, multiplied by the market premium, which is the market rate of return less the risk-free rate. When we go to input this into the calculator, we'll be inputting the market premium section first, multiplied by beta, and finally adding the risk-free rate. Now we're just going to use the simple math functions, starting with the clear and inputting the market return rate minus the risk-free rate, and we're going to multiply that by the beta. And then we're going to add the risk-free rate to give us 0.0825, or round it up to 8.3%. So what can we do with this 8.3%? Essentially, we can take this expected return and compare it to the actual return of the stock. If the actual return is greater than the expected return, that means that the stock is undervalued. However, if the actual return is less than this expected return, then the stock is overvalued. This number can also be used as the cost of equity in a weighted average cost of capital calculation. I hope you've enjoyed this video. Remember to like and subscribe, and check out my channel for more videos revolving around the HP10bII Plus financial calculator.